Here is my start file, field properties. You can download the exercise file and follow along by clicking on the link below this video. In this tutorial, I would like to talk about the properties of fields in an Access database. Setting the properties of fields makes it easier for the user to enter data in Access, and it ensures the integrity of my database so no one can violate these rules. I'm controlling what the user can provide and what the user cannot provide in an Access database. So I would like to start talking about some of the fields. I have the region field, and the region field consists of two characters. And I have the postal code, which consists of 5 digits. I don't want anyone to provide more than 5 digits for the postal code, and I don't want anyone to skip the region field. So let's see how am I doing this. I have to switch to design view by clicking on the design view icon in the upper left corner. In design view, I put my blinking cursor in the region field to reveal the set of properties for that field. Now you can see that the field size is set to 20 for the region. I can make it even less than this. The maximum for a short text field is 255 characters. But I want to look at a property called the required property, which is by default set to no, which simply means the field is not required, which means the user can skip it. But if you change it to yes by double-clicking, then the user cannot skip that field. I'm going to test this property, but by the way, I want to test another property as well. I click on the postal code, and I'm going to limit it, let's say, to 6. So the user cannot type more than 6 digits. I want to switch back to datasheet view, and to do this, I definitely need to save these changes because these are changes to the design. When I click on save, I hit yes. Access is asking me, would you like me to go through the existing records and test them? No, I don't want to do that for now. So I'm switching to datasheet view. Let's type a record. Let's say I'm going to type Walmart. And what if I don't want to provide anything for the region? Remember, I made it a required field, which is mandatory. If I click outside, I get this message box. You have to provide a value for the region. So I hit OK. And what if I try to trick Access by typing a space? If I type a space, Access considers it a valid entry, and it assumes that I entered a value. I'm actually violating the rule. I don't want that to happen, so I'm going to change another property. Before I go back to design view, I want also to test the postal code. So I'll be typing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Remember, I set the limit to 6. If I try to type a 7th digit, Access is not allowing me to do that. So the field size property is to set the number of digits or characters that can be accepted. The required property is to specify whether a field will be a mandatory field or just an optional field. But as you saw, we were able to violate the rule. I want to prevent this violation, so I'll go back to design view. In design view, I go to the region field, the one where I changed the property, the required property to yes, and there is another property called allow zero length, which is set by default to yes. If I double click to change it to no, that means the field is required and you are not allowed to type a space, you are not allowed to type a null value. Now if I try to violate the rule, I can't. Let me check. I save. I don't want to test. And I go back to datasheet view. So if I type in your record, let's say this time, I'll be typing Canadian Tire. And then I try to click outside. Access tells me you can't. You have to provide a value for the region. If I type a space, assuming that I'll be able to violate the rule and I click outside, it tells me no, you can't. The allow zero length is set to no. Now my only option is to type a value for the region. So we learned 2 properties, the required property, which works hand by hand with the allow zero length property, and we learned about the field size property. If I move a little bit to the right, I have a phone number and a fax number. Sometimes we see like a placeholder consisting of some stars and asterisks that's to guide the user to the type of data that we expect. This is called an input mask. and I would like to create an input mask to guide the user to the type, to the size, and the format of phone that I'm expecting. To create an input mask, I switch to Design View. All the properties are set in Design View. I'm talking, let's say, about the fax field, and there is a property called Input Mask. An input mask is a placeholder that appears to the user, consisting of a certain number of stars or number signs, and when looking at these stars or number signs, the user can interpret how many digits or how many characters should be entered and what format is accepted. Creating an input mask at the basic level can be as simple as answering three questions. So if you look to the very right of this field, I have ellipses. I click on the ellipses, and it will open a wizard. It asks me about the type of data that I want to accept. I have some predefined types. I'll be selecting the phone number, and then I click on Next. Here, Access is asking me what type of placeholder would you like the user to see. If I click on the down arrow, I can select whichever placeholder I want, an exclamation mark, a dollar sign. I'll be selecting the star. The next question, when I click on Next, it asks me, would you like just to save the numbers, the digits, or would you like to save the formatting as well? When you have a small number of records, let's say 10,000 records, then it makes no difference. But if you have 10 million or 20 million records, that will be saving lots of resources if you just save the number. But in my case, I don't have so many records, so I'll be selecting the first option. The moment I hit Next, I would have created the input mask. If I hit Finish, keep an eye, the code will appear in the design view in the properties. I hit Finish, and here is the code. Would you like to check this code? Then you have to save, and then go back to datasheet view. When putting the blinking cursor in one of the values under Fax, I should see the input mask. I click somewhere here, and I can see that's the input mask to guide the user to the type, size, and format that we expect. Let's see one more property for the account notes. I have a field for the account notes, and I want to be able to track a history of changes that I make in the account notes, because right now, if I type any value, then I replace it with another value. I don't have any record showing me the previous values. I want to be able to track the history of changes in this field, STR account notes. By the way, I want to provide a nice caption that would be easier for the user rather than the developer name you see right now. So let's switch to Design View. I click on Design View. I'm talking about this field, STR account notes, and I'll be typing a caption. Let's make it just notes. And the property I'm talking about is the last property in the list called Append Only. By default, it is set to no. But if you double-click, you are changing it to yes. What does that mean? It means that whenever you make a change, I'll be storing and tracking a history of these changes. So let's save and then switch to datasheet view. Let's go to that field. It's the last field. And I'm going to expand the field and type. The first comment I want to type, this is a new client. So I typed a value. Now I want to change it. I want to type something different. I'll be typing first order placed. And then I move away. I go back. I want to replace it one third time. 10% discount on future orders. And I keep typing different values. Each value is replacing the previous one. But because we set the append-only property for this field to yes, that means we can track the history of changes. How do we do this? I select any value, and then I right-click. And the last property in the right-click menu, Show Column History. When I select this option, now I can see all the changes and the date and time the change was made. This is the append-only property. I hit OK. In this tutorial, we talked about some of the properties of fields in a database. We talked about making a field a mandatory field by setting the required property. If you adjust the allow zero length property as well, then no one can violate the rule. You can adjust the field width by setting the field size and set the number of characters that can be accepted. You can guide the user to the type, size, and format of data that is accepted by creating an input mask. And finally, you can track the history of changes of a field by changing the append-only property to yes.